Welcome to the worship this morning. If you have any questions, you can sit in the house of the prophet. There is a great program on purpose for life. Welcome to all of you. This is the second time I've been on this morning. As we get started with worship, we have a special event today. Thank you.
I'm going to go to the hospital. Thank you. Thank you. It's a reminder that we're looking at a set of doctrinal ways of Jesus. So, for the court, because we need to be specific and specific. And last week, we looked at the paradox of being humbled in order to be lifted up. And we humble ourselves in order to be lifted up. And paradox is always something that on its face seems like it doesn't make sense. But that is the truth of the matter. The story can only be that, or not, or the world. He said, no, the man of story is because he thinks that there will be a challenger to the kingdom. Richard Rohr, it just so happens, decided that paradox like the Phoenix Oil Revelation essentially reflects the strength of among the people in the history. And in one of those reflections, he said, Jesus as the outcome for the image of Christ consciousness is the very template of total humanity. He is human, yet divine. He is physical, yet spiritual. He is good, and yet good. He is powerful, and yet powerful. But what's the nature of that power that he says we are validating Jesus as the Christ? His power, culminating in sufficiency, and for their beginning. Well, clearly, in the passage that we have before you today, the disciples haven't quite understood the lesson yet, right? So Jesus tells them that one more time, in the middle of this argument about who's going to be the more important, who's the greatest, who's the biggest, who's the best, sin is their guilty people to choose the one that they want. So Jesus touches them once again, and there are a number of verses that we have in Scripture. We find the Scripture, or we find the same thing happening. Sometimes there's wolves and dogs coming up to Jesus and secretly going, hey, Jesus, which one of the Scriptures will be writing this, which one is the position of Christ as the Lord of the Lord? And Jesus says to him right there, and brings to us time and says, this is what's important to be one of the Lord. There's another version where the gospel authors have modified it a little bit to make it seem very specific. Disciples themselves are asking for this position. And so you have Jesus and John's mother come up and say, hey, Jesus, which one of my boys is going to get the special seat of heaven? And so you know what it was like they said, well, that's it. And you have to say, yeah, well, this is not the way we understand leadership. It's a challenge. And then we have the verse today from this 22. Jesus is destined to clarify for this the open door to which has been a bridge or gate to their perception about the nature of Jewish things that could be from a few people and among his disciples. Today, this is impossible for us to become something we have to do, to become something we have to bridge. If we don't know it's possible, it's hard to choose that direction, right? And many of us have grown up in or worked in communities, organizations, institutions, where leadership has really been all about taking yourself on the people of the world. Being the doctor's one. Being the one who tells others what to do. That's the image of leadership that many of us from those practices. Fortunately, it's not the only image of leadership that's true. But Jesus in his time, and the disciples in their time, have witnessed the way in which the Roman authorities, who are the oppressive authorities, view their authority to push them and squash others who were not Roman, especially the Jews. So they have experienced the form of dominating leadership, which is so difficult to set up for the whole lives. The enemy has a literal control to the God who can solve the rest of the world, but after all, he will be able to tell us the rest. But when we're in the process, Luther, a little human, only God can be given by his son, but it's still one who wants to be God. We can turn around the individualism that we experience. The great theologians call that the intellectual person, or the ideal person of time. And so what happens? When we become leaders, we do something in the Are you going to go wake up the witness for some big brother, their second year, still ready to do the same thing? So the lady sisters who come again, the baby did the next sentence that was done to me, and I to endure the good doing to the dead. I didn't ever join a I say, when I was we have skin and skull. The skull was a virtue, and skin was a readiness to be part of that. And when you were a skull, that meant literally we were called the slaves of our skin master. And we had to carry their bags, we had to clean our bags of that, polish their boots for every country. That was what it meant to be a skin master. The first obligation of blood is the first obligation of blood. And blood is the sum and symbol that we belong to God. The Christian is very much the seed of the four components of our power. fear, to friendship, to order. can just jump on it for that sort of thing. Find it again. It's just a good idea. But that's the number that we call it to the people of the country. There's a place that the Alan Court is supposed to have to say the question. There's a place that the Alan Court is supposed to have to say the question. Saturday, I spent 8 hours in Saturday. I think we're not going to be able to do that. It's the center of that trivia for leaders. What happens to this question? How do you listen to one another? We need to listen, we need to listen, especially before we say that finally we serve the leader. The paradox of leadership for Jesus is that to be good leaders, we need to be servants. And in order to be good servant leaders, we need to listen. We need to listen before we start to be thank you for the example that brought so much comfort to this time of life. That brought so much and opposition to what many of us have experienced of Christ's existence. We also thank you for the community that you've created in our lives that have gone before us, the way we've come to work with you, and from the boundaries that you have to the trauma for your leadership. I'm going to
Thank you.